Hey to you. I want to welcome you to another episode of How I Animate in Clip Studio Paint. So today's topic will be using the 2D camera folder. We'll use the previous animation that we was working on to illustrate how to use this feature. So for the purpose of what we're trying to achieve here, we're going to have to spread out the timeline to about 10 seconds. I think 10 seconds should do minimum. So I want you to take your timeline, this little blue thing right here, this little tab, and just drag it all the way out to about 10 seconds. And make sure all your folders and all of those other animations go all the way out for 10 seconds. Now that we've done that, let's go ahead and create the 2D camera folder. So you're gonna come up to animation, new animation layer, and then 2D camera folder. Click on that. We're gonna bring this all the way up here. And this is all of the animation content. And I wanna slide, let's go ahead and select all of these and then slide them all into the folder. So now we have a problem, right? You can see that the video footage for the speed lines is displaying wrong. What you wanna do is come up to the camera folder, go to blending mode, and go to through. And it'll display everything at the settings that the layers and folders are already at. So now that we've created the camera and have all of the content inside of the folder, we wanna make sure we're highlighting that operation tool. It usually automatically selects it, but you wanna make sure just in case before you start working with the camera. So first thing first, let's create some margin room, a little wiggle room for the camera so we can move around with it. I'm thinking here is about enough. Now, when you made that decision to make those changes, make sure you're doing it at the first frame with the camera highlighted. From here, let's zoom in on the timeline a little bit so we can see what we're working with. The first move I want to do is go out about 9-10 frames, and I want to zoom out just a little bit and then come down. It's 9 frames in. And then I'm gonna move over about 4 frames, 1, 2, 3, 4. And I'm gonna zoom back in, but I'm gonna go up. And then I just want you to follow along with me. I'm gonna do about 3 or 4 more. So we're gonna go down, let's say 7 frames. So 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, come here. And we're just gonna move down a little bit. Right? Let me zoom out just a little bit more. All right, we're gonna move down. And then we're gonna go about 3 frames out, say about here. I'm gonna move back up. Then we're gonna move, let's say 6 frames over. 2, 4, 5, 6, somewhere around here. And let's go down, but let's go to the left. And I wanna zoom out just a little bit. Okay. And let's do one more. Let's do about 5 frames. 2, 3, 4, and 5. And we're just gonna move to the right, all right? And from here, what I want you to do is go ahead and select each one of these keyframes. And you can click on each one and hold shift, and it will select the other ones as a group. Now, I want you to leave out the first frame. Why? Because we don't want to go back out to the initial view. We want to keep moving around. So we're going to copy it. Sorry about that, y'all. Just hit copy. And then we're going to go 5 frames out from the last one. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 41. And we're going to right click. And we're going to paste. And I want you to keep doing this until you get to the end. Set 5. Let's go right here. 70. Gonna paste. And just do it again one more time. There we go. And that's it, really. That's all you need to do. Next thing we need to do is export it. And this is very important though, how you export. You wanna come up to File, Export Animation, Movie. Now choose whatever type of file you wanna use, AVI or MP4, that's up to you. Give it a name, save. Hold on 1 second, give it a name, save. This is the important part. You must check Apply 2D Camera Effects. If you do not check this, it will not recognize your camera and it will just play it static. But now that we have the animation 2D camera effect checked, it's going to export with the camera. So let's go ahead and click export and let it do its thing. Now go and find the folder that you saved your video file in. Go and play that animation, and it should look a little bit something like this. I think the 2D camera folder is a powerful tool that everybody should learn to get comfortable with in Clip Studio Paint. I've done a previous tutorial on this, but it was not specifically catered to that. It was something else that I was doing. So I thought I would go back and redo that tutorial, and hopefully this helped you out. If you learned something from this, share it with a friend. Don't forget to drop a like, and as always, anime life forever.
I'm telling my mom.